given the increasingly depressing situation on the ground in the conflict between Israel and Gaza. I want to get your sense of the situation on the ground. So your assessment, if you will, of the Israel-Gaza situation.
Ben Sharon'la Tel Aviv'de görüştüğümde,
when I met Sharon in Tel Aviv, he used an expression saying, "The most enjoyable moments of my life are those when I was on top of tanks in Palestine." I can never forget this. Of course, it clearly displays the viewpoint of one human toward another. At the moment, Israel's position in Palestine is apparent. When we meet and discuss with our American friends, whether it's Mr. Bush or Mr. Obama, they always refer to a two-state structure in the region, in the form of Israel-Palestine. And we kept working on this with Palestine all the time, meaning you accept Israel and let Israel accept you. And facing such a picture, it's beyond comprehension that Israel is still defended by the West and the world is silent about it. Therefore, we cannot remain silent and we will not be silent.
You have you've invoked Hitler in accusing them of their actions in Gaza. You've talked about genocide. Do you stand by those comments?
I completely stand by my comments. Because Nazism, the fascism that was applied by Hitler, if you put all these on the table just like that, you can see that what Israel does to Palestine, to Gaza right now, has surpassed what Hitler did to them. We don't approve. We don't accept what Hitler did either. But right now, we do not accept this persecution, the massacre, the genocide by Israel. Hamas and Fatah unified in respect of this two-state structure, and they formed a national consensus government. Israel does not want this government to make progress. They want to break it up. And in fact, they told this to Mr. Abbas. Mr. Abbas says, "This is the pressure that is applied on me." And he told us this very clearly and openly. Israel is disturbed of a unification here. This is what primarily lies under the problem behind these current attacks.